Hello friends, once again welcome back to my channel Chemistry Med Easy. I hope all of you are watching my channel. My all classes are the continuation of previous classes, so you please do make sure that you watch the videos. The last class we had been discussing measurement of electrode potential. Today our topic is Nernst equation. So in the last class we had been discussing the electrochemical series. What was the electrochemical series? Electrochemical series is an arrangement, it's a series, it's a table containing several electrode potentials. Elements are arranged in the order of their reduction potentials. From that electrochemical series we will get the values of electrode potentials of any electrode. But in that series the electrode potential values are standard electrode potential values. What is electrode potential and standard electrode potential? If an electrode is dipped in a solution containing 1 molar electrolyte. If an electrode is dipped in 1 molar solution, that potential, the potential of the resulting electrode is known as standard electrode potential. But we can change the concentration of the electrolyte solution. If zinc rod is dipped in 1 molar zinc sulfate solution, its electrode potential value measured is minus 0.76 volt. That is obtained from the electrochemical series. Similarly, if we dip a copper electrode in 1 molar copper sulfate solution, the resulting potential is known as standard reduction potential of copper, that is plus 0.34. It is also obtained from electrochemical series. But if we change the concentration of zinc sulfate solution, or if we change the concentration of copper sulfate solution, the corresponding potential values differ. Okay, the potential of the zinc rod is for minus 0.76 only when the zinc rod dipped in 1 molar zinc sulfate solution. The potential of the copper rod is plus 0.34 volt only when it dipped in 1 molar copper sulfate solution. Okay, if we change the concentration of zinc sulfate solution, or if we change the concentration of that copper sulfate solution, the resulting potential may change. Then what is Nernst equation? Nernst gave a relationship between the potential of an electrode and the concentration of the electrolyte solution used. All electrodes, when we consider or when we discuss the type metal ion electrode, that means if an electrode is dipped in its own solution, the potential value of that electrode depends upon the concentration of electrolyte used. Nernst gave a relationship between the potential of the electrode and the concentration of the electrolyte solution used. And that equation is known as Nernst equation. So what is Nernst equation? Nernst equation is an equation connecting the potential of an electrode and the concentration of the electrolyte solution used. Okay, then consider a general reduction reaction of the type. A general reduction reaction can be represented as Mn plus plus N electrode gives F. This is a general form of a reduction reaction. And Nernst gave an equation, and that equation is known as Nernst equation. And Nernst equation can be written as, Nernst equation is an equation for finding the potential of an electrode in non-standard condition. What is non-standard condition? Standard condition means if the electrode is dipped in 1 molar electrolyte solution. If the concentration, if any concentration other than 1 molar, the potential of that electrode can be determined using this particular equation, and that equation is known as Nernst equation. And Nernst equation can be written as E M N plus bar. M is equal to, what is E? Electrode potential. M N plus bar M means M. A electrode M is dipped in its own solution. M N plus. Then the resulting electrode potential, that is E M N plus bar M, is equal to what? E0 M N plus bar M minus RT divided by NF into LN 1 divided by concentration of m n plus. Now we can write concentration of m divided by concentration of m n plus. This equation is known as Nernst equation. Okay, this is electrode potential. E is the electrode potential of that electrode. Then what is E0? E0 is its standard reduction potential. E is the simple electrode potential or reduction potential, but E0 is in its standard case. Actually, this value is available in electrochemical series. We will get the value of E0, E0 of any electrode from the electrochemical series. Almost all electrode potential values of almost all electrodes are listed in the in that electrochemical series. We will get what is the difference between E and E0. E0 represents in the standard condition. E represents is in non-standard condition. Okay, E0 is the standard electrode potential. What is R? R is a constant, that is universal gas constant. Its value is 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. T is the temperature in Kelvin scale. What is N? N is the number of electrons involved in its electrode reaction. N is the number of electrons involved in its electrode reaction. F is Faraday's constant. F is Faraday's constant. Its value is, exact value is 96,487 coulombs per mole. But we can approximate it to, we can take it 96,500. Exact value is 96,487 coulombs per mole. Then this is concentration of metal and this is concentration of metal ion. But concentration of metal can be taken as unity. Therefore, the above equation becomes E m n plus bar m is equal to E0 m n plus bar m minus Rt divided by nf into log 1 divided by concentration of m n plus. This is the form of Nernst equation. This is actually Nernst equation. If you write the Nernst equation of a single rod, what we have to do? We can write first. For writing the Nernst equation of any particular electrode, we can first we have to write its reduction form. You should write equation in the reduction form. For writing the Nernst equation of single rod, first we have to write Zn2 plus 2 electron gives Zn. This is the reduction reaction of that single electrode. So its corresponding Nernst equation can be written as E Zn2 plus bar Zn is equal to what? E0 Zn2 plus bar Zn minus Rt divided by nf into log concentration of Zn divided by concentration of Zn2 plus. But here concentration of Zn is taken as unity. Concentration of all solid is taken as unity. Therefore log 1 divided by concentration of Zn2 plus. This is the Nernst equation of single rod. If we want to write the Nernst equation of copper rod, what we have to write? E Cu2 plus bar Cu is equal to what? E0 Cu2 plus bar Cu minus Rt divided by. Now here also this n value is 2, no? So in this case we can write 2f. Here also n value is, first we have to write the electrode reaction in the reduction form. So if reduction occurs in copper rod, we can write the equation Cu2 plus plus 2 electron gives Cu. So the corresponding Nernst equation is Rt divided by nf. Here also n value is what? 2. So 2f into ln 1 divided by concentration of Cu2 plus. This is the Nernst equation of a copper rod. Then one of the most important application of Nernst equation is, if we can write the electrode potentials of any electrode, we can write the cell potential also. Okay, this is the most important application of Nernst equation. Using Nernst equation, we can write the electrode potentials in non-standard condition. If we can write the potential of single rod like this and potential of copper rod like this, definitely we can write the cell potential value. What is cell potential? E cell is equal to then single rod and the copper rod. Using the single rod and the copper rod, we can construct a Daniell cell, no? We can construct a Daniell cell. So E cell is equal to E cathode minus E anode. In the case of Daniell cell, cathode is copper, anode is zinc. If we can write the potentials of anode and cathode like this, definitely better write cell potential using which equation? E sub is equal to E cathode minus E anode. Next, we have to see how this next equation is applied in the case of Daniell cell. Okay, now let's see next equation of a Daniell cell. Daniell cell is formed by coupling zinc rod and copper rod. Zinc rod is dipped in zinc sulfate solution and copper rod is dipped in copper sulfate solution. If zinc rod is dipped in 1 molar solution of zinc sulfate and copper rod is dipped in 1 molar of copper sulfate, then the resulting cell EMF or cell potential is 1.1 volt. If we use the concentration of electrolyte solution other than unity, we use the concentration of copper sulfate solution other than unity, then that is in non-standard condition. In the case of non-standard conditions, we can use Nernst equation. So, for writing Nernst equation Daniell cell, first we have to write the electrode reactions. Nernst equation in the case of zinc rod, we can write E Zn2 plus bar Zn is equal to E0 Zn2 plus bar Zn minus RT divided by NF into ln. In this case, in the case of zinc rod, the electrode reaction is Zn2 plus 2 electron gives Zn. Actually, in the case of Daniell cell, oxidation occurs in zinc rod and reduction occurs in copper rod. Whatever reactions take place, we should write the reaction in reduction form for writing Nernst equation. So, Zn2 plus 2 electron gives Zn is the reduction form of this zinc rod. So, here n value is 2, so we can write 2f into ln 1 divided by concentration of Zn2 plus. Similarly, we can write Nernst equation for copper rod. The equation is Cu2 plus 2 electron gives Cu. So the corresponding Nernst equation is ECu2 plus bar Cu is equal to E0 Cu2 plus bar Cu minus RT divided by, here also n value is, number of electrons involved is 2. So 2f into ln 1 divided by concentration of Cu2 plus. Then we are going to calculate the cell potential. What is cell potential? E cell is equal to E cathode minus E anode. In Daniell cell, cathode is copper compartment and anode is zinc. So E cathode, E Cu2 plus bar Cu minus E, what is anode? Zinc is anode. So E is a 2 plus bar Zn. So we have the equation of ECU2 plus bar Cu and we also have the equation of Zn2 plus bar Zn. So, substituting these values, so E cell is equal to, that is potential of Daniell cell is equal to potential of copper. What is potential of copper? We can substitute this value. So, E0 Cu2 plus bar Cu minus RT divided by 2F into ln 1 divided by concentration of Cu2 plus minus, what is the value of E Zn2 plus bar Zn? This is the value of E Zn2 plus bar Zn. We can substitute it as E0 Zn2 plus bar Zn minus RT divided by 2F into ln 1 divided by concentration of Zn2 plus. Here E0 Cu2 plus bar Cu, here also E0 Zn2 plus bar Zn. We can put it together. So E0 Cu2 plus bar Cu minus E0 Zn2 plus bar Zn. Then in these two terms, RT divided by 2F is common. So minus RT divided by 2F into ln 1 divided by concentration of Cu2 plus minus ln 1 divided by concentration of Zn2 plus. Then ln A minus ln B, what is ln A minus ln B? Ln A by B. Here E0 Cu2 plus bar Cu minus E0 Zn2 plus
plus 1 Zn is what? E is Cu 2 plus 1 Cu minus E Zn 2 plus 1 Zn is Ezn. Therefore, E0 Cu 2 plus 1 Cu minus E0 Zn 2 plus 1 Zn is E0 cell. That is equal to, so E cell is equal to E0 cell minus RT divided by 2F into Ln concentration of Zn 2 plus divided by concentration of Cu 2 plus. Now here ln A minus ln B, that is ln A by ln 1 by Cu 2 plus all divided by 1 divided by Zn 2 plus. So that is Zn, we come into denominator. So ln concentration of Zn 2 plus divided by concentration of Cu 2 plus. This is the Nernst equation of Danielson. We can write this Nernst equation in a single step by writing its cell reaction. In Danielson, what is actually happening here? Zinc rod get oxidized and the copper rod get reduced. We can write the electrode reaction. Zinc get oxidized, so Zn gives Zn 2 plus plus 2 electron. Copper get reduced, so Cu 2 plus plus 2 electron gives Cu. So the net cell reaction is 2 electron get cancelled. Zn plus Cu 2 plus gives Zn 2 plus plus Cu. Okay. We can directly write Nernst equation. We can write Nernst equation of this Danielson cell in a single step by using this net cell reaction. How? Using this reaction, we can write Nernst equation as E cell is equal to E0 cell minus RT by 2F into Ln. This part, we want to write this part only from this equation. From this equation, the numerator part is product side, concentration of products. Denominator was concentration of reactants. So here in the numerator, what comes? Concentration of Zn 2 plus into concentration of Cu. But concentration of metal is taken as unity. So no need to write concentration of Cu here. Okay, then the numerator, only one term, that is concentration of Zn 2 plus. What comes in denominator? The denominator, two terms, concentration of Zn into concentration of Cu2+. But Zn is a metal, its concentration is also taken as unity. Therefore, in the denominator, only this term involves, that is the concentration of Cu2+. So, we can write Nernst equation by writing the net cell reaction. Okay, then this is the Nernst equation. Similarly, we can write the Nernst equation of any cell from its net cell reaction. First, we have to write the electrode reactions. From that electrode reactions, we can write the cell reaction. From the cell reaction, we can easily write the Nernst equation of that cell. But if you want to write the Nernst equation of an electrode, you should write the reduction form of that electrode, reduction reaction of that electrode. Whatever may happen, but you should write the reduction reaction before writing Nernst equation in the case of electrode. Okay, so this is the Nernst equation. See, we have two electrodes, nickel electrode and silver electrode. Can you construct a galvanic cell using these two electrodes? Definitely, we can construct a galvanic cell using these two electrodes. Here, we have nickel electrode and silver electrode. Here, we are going to construct a galvanic cell using these two electrodes. Okay, here first we have to discuss which acts as the anode. We have to find out which acts as the anode and which acts as the cathode. Here, nickel acts as the anode. Oxidation occurs in nickel rod and reduction occurs in silver rod. How did we understand that? This oxidation reduction tendency, that is obtained, that is available in that series, available from that electrochemical series. We can understand or we can decide which electrode acts as anode, which electrode acts as cathode by looking in that series, electrochemical series. From that electrochemical series, it is clear that nickel acts as the anode. It has greater tendency for oxidation. When we compare the tendency, reduction tendencies of nickel and silver, nickel has lesser tendency for reduction or greater tendency for oxidation. Silver has greater tendency for reduction and lesser tendency for oxidation. So oxidation occurs in nickel rod. So at the anode, what happens? At the anode, oxidation occurs. So nickel is anode, and the oxidation reaction of nickel can be represented as Ni gives Ni 2 plus plus 2 electron. Common oxidation state of nickel is 2 plus. So this nickel removes 2 electrons, loses 2 electrons to form Ni 2 plus ion. So at cathode, what is cathode? Silver acts as the cathode. So at cathode, what happens? The common oxidation state of silver is Ag plus. So Ag plus plus electron gives Ag. But here 2 electrons release. So we have to accept. So the silver ion has to accept. Silver ion accepts 2 electrons. Therefore only 1 electron can accept 1 Ag plus. So let's write it as 2 Ag plus plus 2 electron gives 2 Ag. So its net cell reaction can be represented as this 2 electron get cancelled. So in the left side, Ni plus 2 Ag plus gives Ni 2 plus plus 2 Ag. So we got the net cell reaction in this galvanic cell. Then from this net cell reaction, we can write its Nernst equation. How Nernst equation is E cell is equal to E zero cell minus RT divided by NF into LN. Here the numerator product of the concentrations of products divided by product of the concentrations of reactant. So in the product side, Ni2 plus concentration of Ni2 plus into concentration of Ag square. This is very important. So any coefficient, we should write it as power. Okay, concentration of Ag square divided by concentration of Ni into concentration of Ag plus square. Here, this is metal. This is silver rod. Its concentration is taken as unity. This is also another metal. Its concentration is unity. Therefore, the Nernst equation becomes E cell is equal to E zero cell minus RT divided by NF into LN. Concentration of Ni2 plus divided by concentration of Ag plus square. Okay. In this way, we can write the Nernst equation of any cell. So, we can generalize. Consider a general reaction of the type AA plus BB gives CC plus BD. Its Nernst equation can be written as E cell is equal to E zero cell minus RT divided by NF. NF into, here also this N can be substituted, the value of N as 2. Okay. NF into LN concentration of C raised to C. Here A, B, C, D, small letter A, small letter B, small letter C and small letter D are coefficients. So, concentration of C raised to C into concentration of D raised to D all divided by concentration of A raised to A into concentration of B raised to B. This is the general form of Nernst equation. Nernst equation of a cell. Okay, everything is clear? Then, this we can convert this ln into natural logarithm by multiplying it with the 2.303, or we can write this equation as E cell is equal to E zero cell minus 2.303 RT divided by NF into log. Now this log become log. Log concentration of C raised to C into concentration of D raised to D divided by concentration of A raised to A into concentration of B raised to B. Then 2.303 is a constant, R is a constant, 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. Temperature, we are doing the experiment in room temperature. So temperature is constant. F is already constant, 96,487, or we can take it as 96,500. So all these terms are constant. If we put it as log, then into 2.303 also there. 2.303 into 8.314 into then room temperature. divided by 96,487, then this value, this is a constant, and this value is 0.0591. Therefore, this next equation can be again written as E cell is equal to E zero cell minus 0.0591 divided by n into log concentration of C raised to C into concentration of D raised to D divided by concentration of A raised to A into concentration of D raised to D. This is another form, simplified form of Nernst equation. Okay, then next we have to find the relation between equilibrium constant and standard cell potential. Relationship between equilibrium constant and standard cell potential. Let's consider Daniell cell. What is the cell reaction of a Daniell cell? What are the electrode reactions? That one gives then 2+ +2 electron. Then Cu 2+ +2 electron gives Cu. Then the general electrode reaction, general cell reaction is Zn+Cu2+ gives Zn2++Cu. As reaction proceeds, what happens? Concentration of Zn2+ gradually increases and concentration of Cu2+ gradually decreases. As a result of this, the potential of the cell as reads in voltmeter, that cell potential value keeps on decreasing. As time passes, the cell potential value keeps on decreasing. Then what happens? After some time, an equilibrium is established where there is no change in the concentration of zinc ion and there is no change in the concentration of copper ion. At that time, that voltmeter reads as zero, and that condition is known as equilibrium condition. At equilibrium, E cell value, cell potential value is zero. At equilibrium, what is zero? Cell potential value, E cell value is zero. Okay, then we can write Nernst equation of this Daniell cell as how E cell is equal to E zero cell minus 2.303 RT divided by 2F into log concentration of Zn2+ divided by concentration of Cu2+. Log concentration of Zn2+ divided by concentration of Cu2+. This is the Nernst equation of a Daniell cell. At equilibrium, what happens? At equilibrium, voltmeter reads as zero. That means E cell, voltmeter reading directly gives the value of cell EMF. Therefore, at equilibrium, E cell is equal to zero. Therefore, zero is equal to E zero cell minus so on. So, we can write this equation as E zero cell is equal to 2.303 RT divided by 2F into log. What is this? This is actually equilibrium constant. At equilibrium, this ratio is what? Equilibrium constant. So, E zero cell is equal to 2.303 RT divided by 2F into log Kc. This is the relationship between equilibrium constant and standard cell potential. E zero cell is the cell potential in standard condition. So E zero cell is equal to 2.303 RT divided by 2F into log Kc. Okay. So today we have discussed what is Nernst equation, how we can write how can we write the potential of zinc rod, how can we write the potential of copper rod, in general how can we write the potential of any electrode under non-standard condition, or how can we write the cell potential in the Nernst equation of a cell. Then we discuss the relationship between the equilibrium constant and the standard cell potential. I think everything is clear. Then thanks for watching. Thank you very much. You please to subscribe my channel. My all classes are the continuation of previous lessons. So thank you very much.